Hi you guys, Lindsay here. Welcome back to my channel, Inside the Hem.
Happy National Thrift Shop Day, y'all. You might not be entirely familiar with this holiday, but it was created by Goodwill and is dedicated to promoting the art of thrifting, the practice of shopping for affordable, one-of-a-kind fashions. Across North America on today, August 17th, many Goodwill locations will offer special deals and discounts and events like fashion shows and style workshops to commemorate the holiday. And if you cannot get out to a Goodwill today, no worries. You can celebrate right here with me by checking out my latest refashion. This gingham dress was purchased at Goodwill during my shopping trip that I filmed for the How to Shop Goodwill for Refashioning video. The dress was originally from Talbot and was a size 10. Its straight shape and long hem with virtually no seam lines made it an ideal choice for a refashion. Plus, how cute is that gingham fabric with the embroidered hem? I decided I wanted to maintain that embroidered hem, obviously, but didn't have enough fabric to make it into another dress. So I quickly and easily decided on a top. I did have quite a bit of fabric though, so I knew I could make a top with sleeves. This understanding of how much fabric you have and how much you need to refashion certain garments just comes with time and experience. My best advice is to get a garment and start cutting it up, and then you will quickly realize what you need, how much you have, and what you can make. Ultimately, I decided on Simplicity 8880 for the pattern. It's a sweet little top with sweetheart neckline, princess seamed bodice, gathers at the bust line, a fitted or full lower bodice, and sleeve options. I opted for version D with the puffy sleeve with the elastic hem because I had enough fabric to make the sleeve, so why not? But you better bet I'll be making version B with that ruffle sleeve real soon. As you can see, as I started cutting out the pattern, the hem of the original dress wasn't quite as wide as the pattern piece. Again, with experience, I knew that would be okay as the finished hem width was still much larger than my hip measurement. A lot of refashioning is just going with the flow, using what you've got, and making it work. And hands down, the hardest part is getting the pattern cut out. Once you've figured out that little puzzle, then you just follow the pattern instructions and sew the garment as if you had started with full fabric yardage. So after all the sewing, here's how my top turned out. Isn't she so cute? I love the little bit of ruching in the bodice. The Empire waist seam is super comfy, and how great are those sleeves? I made only one adjustment to this pattern, and that was to let out the sleeve elastic. The elastic that ended up in my sleeve is easily an inch longer than what the pattern calls for. And honestly, it's still a little tight. I could have let it out a little more. Rather than relying on the pattern for this, I would advise you to simply wrap the elastic around your bicep and use that as your measurement. I also made a rookie mistake and sewed the zipper stop way too close to the seam line of the upper back, so now that's starting to come undone. It's an easy enough mending job though to reset it. Anyways, I think it's super cute and super sweet. The gingham with the embroidery is a fabric that I'm not sure I could find at a fabric store. I did check fabric.com and Mood to try and give you guys some options, but I didn't see any gingham embroidered fabric at all. So I feel like I was able to make a truly one-of-a-kind garment thanks to my Goodwill find, and that's the beauty of refashioning. I hope you like my top as much as I do. Give this video a thumbs up or leave a comment if you do. It really means a lot. And when you're done with that, I've got a refashions playlist you can check out to see all the refashions I've revealed on the channel. Hopefully you'll be able to head to your favorite thrift shop soon and find some unique things that you can transform into unique garments. But that's going to do it for me today. Thanks for watching. I will see you all very soon. Bye!